cow protection in the age of Kali. This is mainly dedicated to and based on the teachings of our beloved spiritual master, is Divangesi Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. The age of Kali means mismanagement and quarrel. Mismanagement and quarrel. Everywhere we see mismanagement and quarrel. There are some states, they want a separate state, like Telangana, they want a separate state. And in many other Gurkha land, they want separate state. So everywhere they wanted separate state. So, and even in Kashmir, they want a separate country. So everywhere there's a mismanagement. And so mismanagement. Even in Thailand also, they were opposing the government. So in this way, everywhere there is a mismanagement. There is a mismanagement between a state government, the management of the country. And there is a quarrel everywhere we see. There, this community is fighting with the other community, that community is fighting with this community. So there is always a quarrel among others. The root cause of all management, mismanagement and quarrel is hurting the cow and Brahminical culture, thereby pushing all society towards hell. Yes. So when we are hurting the poor animals, so nature is taking revenge. Because everybody is a son of, everybody is a right to live. Nobody can encroach upon others' right to live. So unnecessarily killing other living entities, it is violating the laws of the God's law. So in this way, just by hurting the cows and disturbing the spiritual practices of a Brahmanas, the society cannot live peacefully. So the bull which is represents the emblem of the moral principle, because bull is considered to be dharma personified, religious dharma personified, and it gives us, the bull works hard and tills in the field and gives us the grains. So it is considered to be father, just like father works hard and maintains the children. The same way, the bull works hard in the field and it produces grains and other foodstuffs for us. And the cow, mother cow, is considered to be the representative of the earth. So mother cow is our mother, because she gives milk to us the whole life. Not only milk, many other milk products. Cow is a representative of earth. Mother cow is an embodiment of 330 million demigods. There are 330 million demigods reside in the body of cows. Every portion, part of the cows, there is a different demigod. So when the cow and the bull are in a joyful mood, it is to be understood that the people of the world are also in a joyful mood. When you see the cows are not in a joyful, cow and bull, so they are not in a joyful mood, then you should understand the people are also not in a joyful mood. The position of cow and bull at the present age. At the present age, in this age of Kali, both the bull and the cow are being slaughtered and eaten up as a foodstuffs by a class of men who do not know what is Brahmin culture. Instead of doing sacrifices in the yagnas and sacrifices, people have started eating animal food. So by thinking that just by having a lot of factories, I can produce nuts and bolts, and I can earn money when I can eat animal foods. But naturally there is a foodstuffs available without when you are hungry, you cannot eat all the nuts and bolts which you are producing in your factories. You have to eat, depend on the nature. So animal food, even animals, they need fodder. So for fodder, you need rain. If you want rain, you should do sacrifice. So in this way, we have to do sacrifice. See, we cannot just depend on animal food. So human civilization means to advance the cause of Brahmin culture. Human civilization is meant for advancing in spirituality and advancing in Brahminical culture. What is Brahminical culture? Truthfulness, cleanliness, mercifulness, duration of life, These are all considered to be brahmanical qualities. But nowadays, people are not clean, not sufficiently intelligent, not truthful, not merciful, not enlightened. So in this way, people are very short living. So these are all, there's everywhere the robbery, thieves, that, so many mistakes, so many problems. So if you want to be remain a truthful, cleanliness, merciful, and to maintain the brahmanical culture, cow production is very essential, because only by cow production you get milk and other byproducts. Only with especially ghee. Ghee is used for performing sacrifices and performing pujas, and even for cooking for the Lord, to offer it to the Lord. And milk products, many curd, ghee, butter, all are very important for our day-to-day life, without which he cannot easily sustain. So human civilization means mainly dependent on natural products like milk and sugar and all vegetables. Human civilization means this, we have to depend on entirely on these products, because there is no suffering in all these things. Especially when an animal is killed, it is undergoing a tremendous tremendous kind of violence, tremendous suffering animals is undergoing. So why should we give trouble to somebody for our food? Everybody has a right to live. Whatever naturally available foodstuffs, why should we not eat and be satisfied? So there's a reference from Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 16th chapter and 20th verse. The mlechas, those who eat meat without performing any sacrifices, are considered to be mlechas. So they make plans to install slaughterhouses and for killing bulls and cows. Along with other animals, thinking that they will prosper by increasing the number of factories and leave our animal food without caring for performance of sacrifices and production of grains. But they must know that even for the animals, they must produce grass and vegetables, otherwise animals cannot live. And to produce grass for the animals, they require sufficient rains. Just by having installing a slaughterhouses and killing bulls and cows, we cannot sustain ourselves. Even for the animals, you need fodder. For fodder, you need rain. To rain, you need to perform sacrifice. So we are completely dependent on the nature's law, the administration of the demigods. Unless they are satisfied, we cannot get rain. If the rain is not there, all other crops cannot grow sufficiently. So we should always perform sacrifices. That sacrifices is mentioned, that will come to later. What are the best sacrifices for this age, that will later will come. The bona fide Vaishyas, the mercantile community, are meant to deal in agricultural, cow production and trade. This is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita 18th chapter and 44th verse, wherein it is said that all the Vaishyas, the mercantile community people, are meant to deal in agriculture. They have to do agriculture and cow production and the trade business. So in this way, this is mentioned specifically in Bhagavad Gita 18th chapter 44th verse. What are the duties of a Vaishya? But in this age, people are become very degraded, and they are supplying the cows to slaughterhouses. See, slaughterhouses. It is said many quotes, one cow in its lifetime can feed 4,44,410 people in a lifetime. But if it is sold for a meat, it can only feed 80 people. So you are getting lot of loss. Even one cow which can give at least 3 lakh, 4 lakhs in its lifetime, when it is sold, you are going to get only 20,000 rupees. So you are undergoing a lot of loss also. Financially also you are getting loss. Even morally, everywhere you are getting losses when you are killing an animal, especially cow. The cow is especially meant to deliver milk for us, and the bull is meant for producing gains. But this in the case of Kali, the cows and bulls are mothers and fathers, unprotected by the mercantile community. They are sent to slaughterhouses. So in this way, great sin is being done. So instead of using the bull for plowing the land, they are using tractors. And in this way, the unemployment is also increasing. And the bulls were there, so in plenty, they used to eat grass, natural available grass, and whatever leftover skins and whatever is there. So that they used to eat and they used to leave. And they used to help us in carrying the goods from one place to another. And they used to help us in plowing the land. In this way, they used to work hard. And nowadays, they were being sent to slaughterhouses and eaten up as a foodstuffs for people. So in that way, tractors has replaced the bulls. The tractors, after being replaced, the employment for people also has come down. So it has increased the unemployment in the society. Next. The cow, however, is our mother. Vedic philosophy teaches there are seven mothers. What are the seven mothers? One is the birth mother. Second is the wife of a Brahmana. Third is the spiritual master's wife. The fourth is the wife of the king. And fifth is the earth. The sixth is the nurse. And the seventh is the cow. These are considered to be the seven mothers for us.